Now I'm coming to the challenges, real challenges what we are facing in the market. Because globalization has helped a lot, but same time they have some challenges. And challenges, if talking about the some challenges I'm here. There is a four kind of challenges. In if you will go for the international business, either for the employment or if you open your own country or trading house in India, then you will get the four kind of challenges. First is your country challenge, right? Because you have to export from India. So there is some challenges of the India, the exporting country challenges. Second challenge is what your factory is doing and your factory challenges. Third challenge is your importing country challenges, right? And fourth is your external challenges. So this is the exporting country challenge. First is the mindset. Many people think that export is not possible or my product is not up to the mark. And he is not able to export because they are not aware of the export. So what happened? The big traders from the metro city, they take the product from those small manufacturer and sell at a high price, right? So we have to change our mindset that the product, every product have a customer. There is a customer for the Zara, there is a customer for the Louis Philippe, there is a customer for the Peter England, and there is a customer for the Atta market, right? So the customers are there for everything, right? So if you have a good product, then you have to go for the US market for the high price. If you have a low product, you have to go for the neighboring country like Bangladesh, Sri Lanka. And you have a down product, you can go to the African market. But customers are there. So you have to grow up with the mindset that if you have a product, you can export anywhere. Second thing is the documentation. Documentation is of course is a, one of the big problem because lots of government and government involvement cause custom and custom is required and sometimes you have to go to the embassies for different legal paper. So you need a professional. So that is an additional cost. So this we consider as a challenge because it must be something smooth. Third is infrastructure. In last 10 years or 15 years, India has grown with the infrastructure very much, but not what we need. We need to do a lot for this infrastructure, but if you compare with the China, we are far behind. So we need to work on that. Infrastructure means what kind of port we have, what kind of road we have, what kind of factory we have. So we need to work on the infrastructure. So that is a challenge for India at the time. Encouragement by the government. I don't know how much of you knows that the government gives the incentive to you. If you are exporting $100 item to any country, the government will give 3-4% back as an incentive to you, right? Whatever amount you are exporting, the government provide you back 3-4% incentive. That is good that government is giving something to promote your export and you're motivating you. But if you compare with the other countries like China, Vietnam, Indonesia, that is the third, Vietnam and Indonesia, that is growing very very fast. So you have to compete with the prices. So government should look at this and to increase the incentive or something in more way. Bilateral trade is important. Actually, what happened? When we export anything and we get the payment in the forex currency like dollar, euro, and any other country like US dollar or Australian dollar, any foreign currency, strong foreign currency, we get the money. But if you talk to the China, they do the business, they go with the bilateral trade, and they do the trading in their own currency, right? If they are dealing with the Russia, they are exchanging in the ruble or they are exchanging in the Chinese yuan, right? So India need to do this kind of thing. Otherwise, what happened? Just 6 months back or 8 months back, rupees was $65. Today is $85. Means 6 months back, when you are going to buy any product, you have paid 65 rupees and now you are paying 85 rupees for the same thing. So the government look at this and go for the bilateral trade so that currency can be Indian rupees or local currency. So this is the one. Second thing is compliances. These are the compliances that are required. The social, if you open a factory, then you have to go through, you have to follow the minimum basis. And fire safety, because there is any standard that is minimum, a particular certain level, you cannot go for the low price. And these are the factory, these are the compliances, means many compliances are required. If you are exporting Africa, then no problem. But if you are exporting to US market, European market, your factory must be as per their standard. Otherwise, they will not take any goods from you. And they have appointed 3 to 4 agencies. They have to audit your factory, and basis of that they make, they give you the go ahead. And if you talk to any European brand or any US brand, they will firstly ask, do you have this kind of certificate or not? If you say yes, then they talk further. Now the third point is socio-political. Third challenge is importing country. The first I told you that what exporting country, then the factory challenges, and third one is very important is importing country challenges. If you are exporting goods to any country, these kind of challenges may come. First is the language. We all know that different company has different languages. English is not something that is spoken everywhere. I'm not taking only 2 minutes. So English is not spoken everywhere. Only 30% population is speaking English worldwide. So you have to, and you cannot learn anything, Spanish, Russian, Chinese. So you have to fight with that, and you have to manage kind of this thing. Sanction. I don't know how many people know the sanction, but since you are a BBA student, so you should understand what kind of what the word sanction. Many times it happens that कोई बड़ा पावर वाली कंट्री होती है, छोटी कंट्री के ऊपर वो सैंक्शन लगा देते हैं उनके हरकतों की वजह से, तो इसमें तीसरी कंट्री को प्रॉब्लम होती है। बहुत बेसिक सा एग्जांपल है ईरान का। ईरान सबसे ज्यादा तेल का इंपोर्टर है, तेल का प्रोड्यूसर है, और यूएस ने उसके ऊपर सैंक्शन लगाया हो क्योंकि वो न्यूक्लियर पावर बना रहा है, राइट। और उसकी वजह से क्या हो रहा है कि पूरी दुनिया में जो अदर कंट्री थे वो उनको एक्सपोर्ट नहीं कर रही है। अब इंडिया को तेल चाहिए तो क्या कर सकते हैं, ईरान से तेल लेना, बट वो सैंक्शन लगा हुआ था, उनको डॉलर में पेमेंट नहीं कर सकते। उस चक्कर में फिर इंडिया और ईरान बायलैटरल ट्रेड में गए कि हम क्या कर सकते हैं, आप मेरे को तेल दे दो, मैं डॉलर नहीं दे सकता हूँ। तो क्या करते हैं, आप मेरे को तेल दे दो, मैं आपको चावल देता हूँ। तो दो गेट दीज कंट्री गो इनटू द बायलैटरल ट्रेड, तो हम उनको रुपी पेमेंट सिस्टम पे काम करते थे। ईरान से जितना भी तेल आता है उसके अगेंस्ट में हम पहले उनको मेडिसिन देते हैं, फिर जो पैसा बचता है उस पर हम चावल देते हैं, फिर जो पैसा बचता है कुछ और दे देते हैं। तो मीन्स आप अपने बिजनेस को बहुत लिमिट कर लेते हैं। तो सैंक्शन इज द थिंग दैट इज अ बिग चैलेंजेस इन द इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस, यू नो, इफ समवन कंप्लीट्स दिस। सिविल वॉर आप अभी गवर्नर सुन रहे होंगे, पाकिस्तान की कहानी, फिर यमन की कहानी, वेनेजुएला की कहानी, श्रीलंका आपने देखा होगा, तो इस तरह से सिविल वॉर चलते हैं। तो आप ऐसे चैलेंजेस में आप एज ए सेल्स पर्सन नहीं जाके उस कंट्री में बात कर सकते हो, अपना माल बेच सकते हो, तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज। इकोनॉमी स्लो डाउन कभी कभी हर जगह पे लगा रहता है, एवरीथिंग इज डिपेंड ऑन द एनर्जी प्राइसेस। तो अभी यूक्रेन रशिया वॉर चल रहा है, पेट्रोल के प्राइस बढ़े हुए हैं, गैस के प्राइस बढ़े हुए हैं, तो यूरोप इसका बहुत बुरी तरह से हिट है। तो इसी तरह से कभी ना कभी कोई ना कोई 2008 में यूएस के साथ था, तो इकोनॉमी स्लो डाउन में आपका बिजनेस रुक जाता है, दैट इज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज। करेंसी फ्लक्चुएशन, समटाइम योर करेंसी गोज डाउन, वी आर ब्लेस्ड दैट हमारा करेंसी 60 रुपए से 80 रुपए पे है, बट मेनी कंट्रीज लाइक लेबनीज पीसो वहाँ पे 1,00,000 रुपए तक जा चुका है। अर्जेंटीनियन करेंसी, इनके भी बुरे हालत हैं। तो इफ एनी कंट्री हैव अ डाउट, इफ एनी कंट्री करेंसी इज गोइंग डाउन, डिक्लाइन, इट इज वेरी चैलेंजिंग फॉर एक्सपोर्टिंग दैट कंट्री। और फिर लास्ट में आता आपकी खुद की प्रॉब्लम, आपका जो प्राइस है महंगा है सस्ता है। एंड सेकेंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, मोदी साहब टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेक इन इंडिया प्रोग्राम, सो एंड आफ्टर दैट मिस्टर ट्रंप हैज स्टार्टेड टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेक इन यूएस, सो एवरीवन इज टॉकिंग इन देयर ओन कंट्री, एवरीवन वांट टू मेक देयर ओन कंट्री। एंड देयर इज 195 कंट्रीज, सो वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मेक अ ब्रांड इन 195 कंट्रीज। And we also, the biggest challenge is also the external factor, like we are not making everything. We produce many things, but our raw material comes from China. So that is a big challenge for the India as of now. But I'm very sure very soon we will get out of that, and we our export will grow up. But export is a very nice thing, and India is India growth business is growing every year. And thank you so much for your time and support and calling me here. Thank you.